Hello guys, welcome to our fourth tutorial of this CSS animation crash course. In this tutorial, we are going to be looking at keyframes. To me, keyframes are the most important thing when it comes to animation, because they define our animation by telling CSS how we want our animation to work. So with keyframes, they tell you mostly about two things. The first thing is they tell you what the action of your frame is at a certain point of time. And then secondly, it will tell you what time that action will occur. So when dealing with keyframe, you need to create a keyframe block. And you create a keyframe block for every element that you want to add keyframes to. And to start with keyframes, so let's say for example, we get our file open up here. This is our HTML file. And then we also have our CSS file. Our file is open up in our browser here. So this whole thing, this is just pure HTML. We cover all this in our HTML crash course already. So, and then this is our pure CSS. We cover all this in our CSS crash course already. So I'll leave the link to those crash courses in the description in case you want to check them out. But this code here is what made up this page here. You see, this is like the sky, the sun is shining there, this is the grass, and then the gyro. This is our HTML here. So now we want to at least create a person riding a bike. So we want to add a keyframe where they will be able to ride from here to here. They're coming from here to here. And to do that, we already have our image in our root folder here. This is our root folder. So if you look into image, we have this image here. So this is the image that we want to use. So let's just add that to our file. We come inside our road class there. That's where we are going to be adding our image. So I want to add an image, and then this image I want to give it a class name of bike1. And then I'll just press enter there, and then that will be created. So the source of this image is, we know it's in the folder called images, and the name is bike, and the format is png. So the source there is images/bike1.png. That's the format. Control L to save. And then come into your browser, refresh. So you can see you got your bike there. That's your bike. So now let's just move on to our CSS so that we can style our bike guy there. So to style that, we have to call it. We already know our class name is bike. It's bike one. Our class name, this is our class name here, bike one. So we have to call that. Let's just add some simple CSS. Let's just say we want to position it, let's say absolute. So we want to give it some margin to the top, let's say to zero, some margin to the left, let's say to zero as well. Let's give it the height, just change the height there, let's say 80 pixel, and then the width, let's say we want to make it 100 pixel. Right, save that, come in here, and then refresh. So you can see you got your bike there. Right, so now you want to add a keyframe where it's riding from here to here, from here to here. So to do that, you have to create a keyframe block. So to create a keyframe block, just add keyframe. Add keyframes, and then you give your keyframe a name. Let's say I'm just going to give mine a ride, and then open and crossing carry brackets. And the reason you are giving your keyframes a name, it's for you to be able to use it earlier. So if you didn't give your keyframes a name, then there is no way you are going to be able to call it or use it later. So make sure that you always give your keyframes a name. It doesn't really matter what names you give it, just as long as you give it a name. So now you come inside your open and care and crossing carry brackets here. In this keyframes block, there are two key words that you have to add in. So the keyframe, this will set how this person is going to write from here to here. So inside here you have to insert two key words. The first one is from, where you want the person to write from, and then the second keyword is to, where you write, where you want the person to write to. So now you come in here, you want them to start writing from here to here, right? So you add in from, you add your transform, you want to translate X. You are translating X because you want to write from left to right. So this is along your X axis. So you are translating X. And this time you want to start from zero, right? You want them to start where they are here. So, and then you want to, where you want them to write to, it's here. So now you come to, you transform, again, translate, and still you are translating X since you want them to write along your X axis. So, but then this time, let's say you want them to write to this part. So let's say 1000 pixel. That's where you want to write, since you want them to write from here to here, somewhere here. So let's just put 1000 there. So now you control S to save, come in your browser and then refresh. As you can see, nothing is happening. You are probably asking yourself, like, what did I do wrong? Well, I'm here to tell you that you didn't do anything wrong, but you are just not done yet. So now that you set your keyframe there, you actually have to call it out. For it to work, you have to call it out. And you know you are targeting your bike one there, so you have to call, come inside there and then call it. At first you want to give it an animation name. You want to call out the animation name. This is the name that you are going to be using, which is right the same name that you name your keyframe proc. And then the second thing is the animation duration. And the animation duration just means like the time that you want the person to write from here to here. So you are setting the time that you want your animation to take when writing from here to here. So in this case, let's just make it, let's say, 4 seconds. Save that and then come in your browser, refresh. As you can see, the person is now writing from there to here. So just refresh that and then see it's writing from there to here. And then once it reaches here, it just bounced back to here. So we will fix that in our next tutorial. But for now, just know that this is how you create a keyframe. You just have to create a keyframe block. Make sure you give it a name and then insert two keywords. There is actually another way you can write your keyframes, but that is a bit more advanced. But for you as a beginner, this is just what you need to know, that you set two, so you insert two keywords in here, which is from and to, and then set your animation. And then once you are done setting your keyframes, you come into what you want to target, call your animation name, give it your name, and then set your animation duration. And then that will be it. So yeah, that's it for this tutorial. I hope you find this tutorial helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you have any question, then leave it in the comments down below and we will definitely get back to you. And if this is your first time, then please consider subscribing so you don't miss out on any content that we'll be posting. So yeah, this is it for this tutorial. I will see you guys in the next tutorial, where we are going to be looking at how you can add more properties to this animation. So yeah, I'm out.